Native people, Native culture, Native knowledge. Hi, I'm Jeannie Green, bringing you award-winning Heartbeat Alaska.
Bringing you national and international Native news, this is award-winning Heartbeat Alaska, the premier Native voice in Native programming.
There's a heartbeat loud as thunder. Revolution is in the air. There's a heartbeat deep inside our mother. Are you too cool to care?
Now, with Heartbeat Alaska, here's Jeannie Green.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Heartbeat Alaska, Native news and Native information. I'm Jeannie Green. The best part of Heartbeat Alaska is you. And I'd like to remind you, even before we begin today's program, to get out your camcorder and get me greetings for our Christmas special that's coming up soon. Please don't miss out on greeting your friends and relatives all over the United States and Canada. On today's program, we visit the beautiful town of Juneau, Alaska, and meet with two very fascinating people there, Beatrice Brown and her son, Greg. We'll be back with Juneau, Alaska, right after this.
Happy Thanksgiving to all Heartbeat Alaska viewers from the Native Village of Aglukark.
Heartbeat Alaska thanks Wave Wholesale Company, your one-stop supply source for village retail stores, food service customers, and government agencies. Welcome aboard, Wave.
Heartbeat Alaska thanks Era Aviation for sponsoring us through our stories. Era Aviation, serving Anchorage, Cordova, Homer, Illiamna, Kenai, Kodiak, Valdez, Whitehorse, and 20 Western Alaska villages from Bethel. Thank you, Era Aviation. We appreciate your sponsorship. Visit Era Aviation at www.eraaviation.com.
Support for this program provided by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Alaska. We've been giving Alaskans the support they need since before Alaska was even a state. And we'll be here when you need us. We're here. We're with you. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Alaska.
I was born in Juneau, yes. My husband was born in Glacier Bay. My mother comes from Angoon. She's a Tekwedi, which is a bear clan. My father is a Thunderbird, comes from Klekwan, Haines area, but they stayed in Huna because my grandmother is from Huna, my father's father is from Sitka.
Beatrice Brown is a blessing. She's known as a hard worker, a blessing to her families and friends and workers. And that hard work began long ago.
I had three girls first, then the boys came. The seven boys came, then a girl, then another boy and a girl. So I had 13 children. And I more or less grew up with them, but because of the father, my husband's strictness and things, you know, we learned everything that he taught we had to learn. But we all worked together. Greg was a real hard worker. The boys were all hard workers. You know, we didn't have TV then. We had running water, we had stove, we had wood, but everything we got, they worked for it. They packed water. If our water was frozen, they chopped wood, they got wood. They went after wood, they went fishing. They learned all these hard things from the time they were real young, all of them. But Greg was the most active among them. He worked extra hard.
Beatrice Brown shouldn't be here, but she is. She's a walking miracle. And during this holiday season, everyone enjoys a story with a happy ending. And this story has one. But it began with a tragedy.
She had a real close call about 25 years ago, I think. Maybe less than that, about 15 years ago, where she got caught underneath the same boat, my dad's same boat, in fact. One of my nephews had fallen in off the boat while it was running. My mom didn't want to see us lose him, so she ran and jumped in overboard for him. And when they came back around to pick him up, she got caught underneath the prop and got sucked underneath the boat, and we almost lost her that year. She has a real good story on that one, too. She lost her arm and part of her scalp, and she really got chopped up underneath there, but she lived through it. She got her arm reattached, too, so that was the first time ever, from what I understand.
And Seattle doctors told me, Mrs. Brown, you are never going to go back to work. You're not going to work. You have to learn how to live your life over again. You have to learn a lot of things. We don't know how far you're going to go, but you're not going to work again. You're not going to do anything because you're going to be crippled. I had to learn how to walk. I had to learn how to dress. I had to learn how to eat. I had to learn how to use my hand. I was a right-handed person. I became a left-handed. So I couldn't walk. I couldn't dress. I couldn't put my own clothes on. I couldn't do anything. So just like a brand new baby, I had to do all these things again. I had to learn how, and when I was home for 1 year, they told me, well, I was going back down to Seattle for checkups, after checkups. And this one night when I came here to Juneau to the hotel, there was somebody that came to my door and told me that, he said, Beatrice, your life was put, you were put back on this earth for a purpose. The life you're going to lead now is going to be different. But if they ask you to go back to work, you go back to work. If people need your help, you help them. Anybody that asks you of any kind of help, help them. But always use my name to witness. So right there I knew that was an angel. I knew someone sent this person to me. So I sat there and I said, yeah. I didn't look at him. I just had my head down and sat on my bed and was listening to him. He said, your life is going to be well rewarded for the things you do. And after that, I was home already, 2 years? 3 years, then I got a job. I was a site manager for the elderly people in Hona. I became a site manager. It was a new program at the time. So the people that came to me was from Juneau. So they told me, everything's going to be all set out for you, you don't have to do nothing. I told them, I can't work. I was in a boating accident, I can't do nothing. They said, we know that. We heard about all the things you already went through. But we just want you to be the site manager. You're not going to do anything. We're only going to open the place twice a week. I said, oh. I said, okay. I said, I'll give it a try. So after they left, then my husband and my daughters and we sat around and talked about it. Then my husband said, honey, remember that person that came by you at the hotel? You said it was an angel. And I said, yeah. He said, I think you better follow whatever he said. So the next day we brought the minister up, our minister, and us were real close. So we talked about it. And so he said, okay, we better keep track of this. Let's keep praying about it. That's what we did. And I started on the job. I started the site manager job. And pretty soon I wasn't paying attention to myself. I was more worried about the other people that was going to come to the place.
Other people, caring for them, helping them, loving them. That's what Beatrice Brown and her son Greg Brown are all about. Greg works for Hope Community Resources in Juneau. In his spare time, he teaches the youth traditional dances, keeping the culture alive while guiding and caring for the youth.
The kids are great. I told them the only requirement I had for any of the children to learn was that they had to be committed and they had to be discipline themselves to make it to practices and sing and dance, and I'll do the rest. And they've been that, they've done that. Just by the amount of awards that we won in 1 year, shows us that these kids are really serious. And I'm really proud of them, I really am. Even with such a big group as that, we've come a long ways. We've done a lot of things. We learned a lot of things. And it's still helping them out quite a bit.
The stories of Beatrice Brown and her son Greg are inspiring, hopeful stories. And during this holiday season, we hope we've brightened up your day with this happy Thanksgiving story. For Greg and Beatrice Brown have much to be thankful for, and we're thankful for them. Happy Thanksgiving from Heartbeat, Alaska. And now for some music videos, and I'll be back right after that.
We're all the same. Oh, Siem, we're all the same. radio tan ang ospital. Di po hin. Ego. Hindi mo tayo. Ego niya, mas nandang po ospital.
Hey, if you're going to be flying, check the weather before you leave and always file a flight plan. I'm Steve Haldane for Coca-Cola and Heartbeat Alaska. See you next week.
Dziś nie ujacham, 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 dziś nie uj
Thank you everyone for joining us for Heartbeat Alaska, Native news and Native information. And I'd like to remind you once again to get your camcorder out. Our Heartbeat Alaska annual Christmas special is coming soon, and I don't want you to miss out on this one. God bless every single one of you, and we'll see you again next week. Oh,
What?